everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today I am going to do the $10 Dollar Tree makeup. I don't even know if I have 10 products. I guess I only have 9. So anyways, I am going to hop on this bandwagon and try and do this, I guess, tutorial or challenge or whatever you may call it. But anyway, so basically what it is instead of using drugstore makeup or, you know, more high-end department store makeup, I am going to try and do a full face with just makeup you can get at the Dollar Tree. First, I am going to use a moisturizer. I just washed my face. So I'm trying out some products from my Ipsy bag. So I am trying this. It is the In Transit Camera Close-Up Mask Moisturizer and Primer in One. So I'm gonna go ahead and prime my face first with this. I don't know if I saw like a primer there, so. Actually really liking this product. It's very hydrating. Although it does take a little bit to set. And me rubbing my face is making me really red. So the first product I'm going to try is the LA Colors Liquid Makeup in True Beige. Again, all of this is a dollar, so. They didn't really have a variety of makeup, like as far as colors. So I'm hoping this isn't too like, looks really, really light. So I don't know, maybe we can bronze it up a little bit. Like broke. Oh my goodness. Although it does have like a little pump, but since it's pretty much already open, I'm just gonna put some on my hand. Oh yeah, this is not the color for me. I am gonna use my normal makeup tools, so I'm gonna use my Beauty Blender and try this out. Oh goodness. Oh goodness. This is not going well. Katie's laughing at me in the background. This is just getting worse. Oh my goodness. So maybe after I swipe this all over my face, I'm gonna blend it out with my Beauty Blender or something. Oh my goodness. Okay, so let's try and I guess blend this in now. I'm just using my viewfinder as a mirror. Which may be best. I'm using this as kind of like a concealer too, for like my under eyes and everything, because we didn't really have a concealer there. I feel like I really have to like cake this on and then blend it a little bit. And then it kind of builds up the coverage a little bit better. So, I mean, I guess it's okay. In the lighting, it probably looks a little bit better than maybe it would without my lights. But you can like visibly tell it's not the same color. But I'm hoping that with bronzer, it will sort of look like my color. Yeah, it's in like just my mirror, it looks very pink, very, very pink. And on camera, it may not be too bad, but in person, it is very pink. Not really my color. I only saw maybe two other colors, knobs were really close. They just got lighter and lighter. Okay, so on to the next product, which is going to be, I guess we'll just do regular face powder. Hopefully that'll kind of mattify and blend it a little bit better. So I'm using the LA Colors Pressed Powder in Tan. And this looks a lot darker, so this may be what kind of helps a little bit better. I will go ahead and try and use this little sponge that is super thin. We'll see how this works. And then if not, I'll just use my regular powder brush. And it's picking up a lot, so I feel like this is just going to literally, yeah. Definitely darkened it up though, but this is not working out. So I'm just gonna use a regular powder brush and see if that helps. The foundation actually sets pretty quickly. Powder is definitely very like chalky though. I'm gonna use a different brush now to kind of set a little bit under my eyes with the same powder. Going to do my eyes. So I'm going to use this LA Colors in traditional. It's 12 color eyeshadows. 12 rich intense colors in one palette. Colors, they're all kind of like nude colors, which is what I like more. So Katie's over there making a ton of noise. You're screeching and crunching, that's her. Go ahead and grab my shadow brush, and they're not labeled by colors or anything, so I'm going to use this light pinker color. They are pretty shimmery. I don't think there's really any matte colors in this palette. It does seem like there's quite a bit of fallout too. Oh, you know what? I think what I'm gonna do, so maybe we, well, yeah, I think I will. I'm gonna go ahead and prime my eyes with my Urban Decay eyeshadow primer, just to see if it kind of helps with picking up the color a little bit better. My headband's falling off. Boom, there it goes. So anyways, like I said, using the Urban Decay eyeshadow potion, I'm just gonna go ahead and put that on my eyes and see if that helps with picking up the pigment of the eyeshadows a little bit better. Okay, so don't feel like this is very easy to blend. Okay, so now that that's on, I am going to go ahead and usually do like a matte color in my crease, but I think I will just use this color here. Probably zoom you guys in a little bit more. So anyways, now that I zoomed you guys in, I'm gonna use again this brown color here and try and blend that into my crease. The pigment on this is actually not too bad. As you can see, it really is picking up a lot. It could be the Urban Decay. So I'm just going to, I think what I'm going to do is just put a little bit of that base powder into my brow. I guess I could have tweezed a little bit here before doing this video, but that's okay. I really don't want to put shimmer up on my brow bone, but I think I'm going to anyway. I'm just going to grab the light color here, this white, and kind of put it up on my brow bone. And then I'm going to take this fluffy brush again and everything a little bit better. Next, I am going to line my eyes, and I am going to use the LA Colors Liquid Eyeliner in black. It's actually a very fine tip. Oh, there you go. Now you can see. So it should give me a pretty clean line. I'm gonna use my little hand mirror. I'm a big fan of like winged eyeliner on me. Kind of impressed with how well that lines. Not too bad. Not too bad at all. For the old stuff, it's too bad. Next, I am going to use the LA Colors, this is another eyeliner, auto eyeliner in the color Black Brown. I'm gonna try and use this for my brows and for underneath my eye. It's definitely not, it definitely like drags on your eye. Oh, I'm like not even in the shot. It's just like there's really not a whole lot of control over it. So it looks really like Versace. So yeah, I'm not really sure about this. I'm gonna try and use it for my brows. Have like a spoolie. A spoolie would like work better to kind of even it out. I am going to bronze up my face and put some blush on. Actually, I should probably put on mascara. Let's do mascara. Finish up my eyes. I usually do mascara like as the last thing, but just so I can finish up my eyes for now. Oh no, smudge my eye. No, mascara's not too bad. I guess we'll just have to see how it does with like the rest of the day. Like I'm sure it'll probably flake off, but if you were out and about and maybe forgot mascara, or maybe, I don't know, in an emergency situation and you needed mascara real quick, this would be good. So I have pretty long eyelashes, so I don't know. For someone that has shorter eyelashes, if this would make it, you know, make them look longer or thicker. I don't think. Just says mascara. It's not like a. Just says lash building formula. So it doesn't really advertise as like volume or lengthening or anything like that. Okay, so let's finish up the face. You use the bronzer, there it is. Again, LA Colors in just bronze. It is a shimmery bronze and not a matte bronzer. Whoa, it's very powdery for sure. It's like when you pick it up, it's very, very powdery. It's actually pretty. I'm not gonna lie. Pretty good for like the beach or something like that. It's actually not too bad. Use the LA Colors Peach Rose Powder Blush and Brush Applicator. Soft, silky texture, highlight cheeks. Oh no, I got this foundation on my shirt. Again, a lot of fallout, so you do have to be really careful not getting it all over the face. Not too bad. And lastly, I am going to do I guess I should have showed you what I was going to use. So it is the Color Mates in Soft Plum. It's moisturizing and long-lasting color. I don't have anything on my lips, not chapstick or anything like that. It is very, very hydrating, actually. Very. Okay, my camera just shut off. Not sure what happened, but anyways, so this is the final look. My lips are very shiny. I feel like I am very shiny and shimmery, but it actually isn't too bad. Other than the fact that the foundation is completely off from my neck, like you can definitely tell a big difference. It actually really isn't too bad. I mean, I would I'd rock this, I'll wear this for the rest of the day. Dollar Tree actually has some good products. Thank you guys so much for watching my channel. Go ahead and thumbs up this video and click subscribe to continue to watch more videos just like this. And make sure to check out my other channel where I vlog. I'll go ahead and put the links below, and I'll see you guys in my next video.